to watch my father's face when I'm sitting here with the governor, man. This really
kicks. He is a one-man radio gang, the Terminator, they say, of morning drive, and he's arrived in Indianapolis.
Howard Stern is on the air in central Indiana, and Fox 59's Russ McQuay tells us he set his sights on the reigning radio legends.
Is Indianapolis ready for Howard Stern?
Today's show is the first time we're broadcasting into Indianapolis.
You can't blame a radio station. It's my screw-up.
The lanky, cross-dressing shock jock who brought nudity, gratuitous vulgarity, and an alter ego named Buttman to American radio hit Indianapolis airwaves this morning.
I'm a little curious. What's going on?
Howard Stern.
Howard Stern.
Yeah.
I thought I was on the wrong station.
He brings artists, he brings all kinds of talent to his show every morning that we don't have right now as far as morning shows.
When Robin said, your favorite person is coming into the room, I really thought I was going to walk into the room.
The morning shows that he seems to compete especially well against are ones that are Bob and Tom like in nature.
Nobody from Q95 was available for comment after WNAP fired the opening salvo in this radio war this morning by faxing over a copy of their press release regarding Howard Stern to Bob and Tom, the current kings of morning drive. Bob and Tom have made it clear they despise Stern, who appeals to the typical Q95 listener.
We've just added WNAP FM 93.1, the great MS broadcasting station in Indianapolis. It's about time we've been on there. We're going to kick some ass in Indianapolis.
Indianapolis.
Bob and Tom show.
Yeah, they got two idiots on there have been ripping off my material for years, so we welcome them, and we will be number one in 3 weeks.
Q95.
For more than 10 years, Bob and Tom have faced down all previous pretenders to the throne. But now a new king has come to town to steal their crown. Russ McQuaid, Fox 59 News.
Another hot shot on Indianapolis radio, WNAP introduced the self-proclaimed king of all media to its morning show today.
Eyewitness News reporter Yolanda Walker tells us the shock jock surprised listeners because the station did not make any announcements about its newest hire.
The shock jock hit Hoosier airwaves this morning. FM station WNAP welcomed Howard Stern as part of his 44th birthday celebration.
Today's show is the first time we're broadcasting into Indianapolis. We've just added WNAP FM 93.1, the great MS broadcasting station in Indianapolis.
I heard the show first thing this morning and I thought it was a mistake.
But it's no mistake. Listeners can catch Stern's show every morning from 6 to 10 a.m. on NAP. And today he already took shots at his number one Q95 competitors, Bob and Tom.
They got two idiots on there been ripping off my material for years, so we welcome them, and we will be number one in 3 weeks.
We talked to Tom by phone.
Howard is such a liar. We're not worried about Howard Stern. We have a much more creative, funny show than he has, and his brand of New York poison won't fly very well here.
Stern's bar none, tell it like it is style is his trademark. He often features porn stars and strippers on his show, not to mention the racial and sexual jokes he tells. But people seem to like him. He's heard in 40 other cities, and his best-selling book, Private Parts, turned into a movie about his career. But how well will his show play here?
I can't stand his show. I think he's raunchy. He's disrespectful. I think he's very crude.
I think he'd do well.
I don't see anything that people can't like about Howard Stern. And if they don't, they can turn it off.
While some may do that, many will tune in as the morning radio battle in Indianapolis heats up. Yolanda Walker, Channel 13, Eyewitness News.
And listeners lit up the phone lines at WNAP with both negative and positive calls after Stern hit the airwaves. Station owner Jeff Smullyan says research showed that Howard Stern will do well here.
Well, he's known for making waves on the radio waves, but now Howard Stern will battle Q95's Bob and Tom.
Stern's show can already be heard in many of America's largest cities and beginning today in Indianapolis.
It sure does. I would like to go on in Indianapolis and take Bob and Tom and toss them on their butts.
That was Howard Stern a year ago while publicizing his movie, Private Parts. This is Howard Stern today.
Today's show is the first time we're broadcasting into Indianapolis. We've just added WNAP FM 93.1.
What we have seen when you bring Howard into a market is it really evens the score.
Long known as a shock jock, Stern has a reputation for sexual stunts on his program. He's been accused of plenty of publicity stunts as well.
And I've always felt that being on the radio is when I'm real. And when I'm off the air is when I'm a fake.
We're going to kick some ass in Indianapolis. Yeah, they got two idiots on there, been ripping off my material for years, so we welcome them, and we will be number one in 3 weeks.
This is the Bob and Tom Show. Good morning.
Like Stern, the Bob and Tom Show also has listeners across the country in syndication. In Louisville, Kentucky, the two shows go head-to-head, and the ratings run neck-and-neck. WNAP is hoping to lure part of the audience from Q95's top-rated morning show.
Howard isn't for everybody, but he's certainly proven in all these different markets that he's more popular and more mainstream than he's ever been, and more people want to listen to Howard Stern than don't want to listen to Howard Stern.
Q95 management was not commenting on the news today. Stern's show can be heard in 41 cities. Bob and Tom's show in 31. They will now compete head-to-head in five cities across.
Well, if you turned on your radio this morning and you expected to hear classic rock, you were probably shocked by the nation's number one shock jock.
Today's show is the first time we're broadcasting into Indianapolis. We've just added WNAP FM 93.1. Right. It's about time we've been on there. We're going to kick some ass in Indianapolis. Yeah, they got two idiots on there, been ripping off my material for years, so we welcome them, and we will be number one in 3 weeks.
Well, there he is. Howard Stern hit the airwaves this morning in Indianapolis on WNAP FM. The station will air Stern's internationally syndicated show from 6 to 10 a.m. Stern also authored two best-selling books and starred in the hit movie based on one of those books called Private Parts.
Well, his radio show and radio stunts are syndicated across America, and now Howard Stern can be heard right here in Indianapolis. WNAP began running Stern's show this morning from 6 to 10 a.m. That means Stern will be going head-to-head with the top-rated Bob and Tom morning show on WFBQ.
What good radio is about is good competition, and there's a lot of good radio stations in this market. That serve a lot of different listener needs. And Howard's show is very much different than Bob and Tom's show.
WNAP signed a multi-year contract with the Stern Show. Management at WFBQ was not commenting on the move today. Stern Show can be heard in 41 cities across America. Bob and Tom's show is in 31. The shows go head-to-head in four cities.
Clash of the Radio Titans.
Boy,
huh?
That's the truth.
Okay.